So we were discussing about the sources of the biomass. Like first was the field and plantation biomass, then urban waste biomass, then industrial biomass. These all biomass sources we have discussed. Now let's start today with that was your forest biomass. So what are the sources for the forest biomass? The first one is log residues. Clear? Then log residues, consists of the residues like of the log of woods that are residues after the residual material or residual wood after the logs are cut. Then timber is basically a sort of a wood also. Then forest floor debris, the forest floor means that the, you can say the wood or the particles that are drawn from the trees onto the floor of the forest that are also, we can say, considered for the sources of for the can say preparation of biomass. Then animal carcass, animal which died in the forest or anything like this, we do this. Then the carcasses of that animal basically can also be used for the as an input for the generating of biomass. Then again comes is your aquatic biomass. So aquatic means basically water. The biomass that is considered by the we can say in water. Plants and all, then the sources for that normally include that is your seaweeds. Example, kelp is a sort of a seaweed. Weeds are basically that are we can say the plants that shrubs or plants that grow in within the water. Then freshwater weeds. Then again the freshwater weeds like weeds that get we can say that are. Can say that take generated inside the fresh water that is the water hyacinth. Then dead fishes that are dead, they keep floating on the surface of the water in between that water, means carcasses of the dead fish. Then microalgae blooms. So microalgae blooms are basically the algae is the green type of layer that is generated on the top surface of the water and on the sides of the, we can say, the stream like this. So these are also, we can say, that can be the inputs for your generation of the biomass. So that can also be the sources for possible sources or potential sources for the generation of biomass. Then, but how far as the utilization of biomass is concerned by this part? That is like the first is like biogas. The energy services is provided by the biogas. Biogas can be used for cooking purposes, like it can be used, it is being supplied to the food for the process of cooking food and all. Then heating, that can be used for heating, that can be your heating of the, we can say, the food items or the heating of, we can say, the space, floor, anything like the case. Then third one is electricity, local pumping, milling, lighting and possible distributions via utility grid. So biogas can also be used for the generation of electricity. Yes, so that and that can that electricity can be used to power a number of we can say sources, like it can be used for local pumping of water. Yes, it can be used for milling purposes. It can be used for lighting purposes. Clear? And like lights are being lighting purposes are being used in our homes and factories. In this case, in the commercial purposes. Then the possible utilization via utility grid. So when we take off it like from utility grid, clear? So that is like when it is being connected to the utility grid, they are supplied for this, they are having and that can be used for your, you can say, connection with the utility grid. From the grid, it is being supplied to the home, to the factories, to the commercial spaces, to the shop. Clear? So from there it can be used as a source of your generation of this. Then producer gas again is a form of this biomass. It is producer gas can be used for electricity. And these are all sources, like it can also be used for the local sources like local pumping, milling, lighting and possible distribution via utility grid. Yeah, so all it can be used for generation of electricity, and then generation electricity can be used for the pumping of water, for the milling, for the lighting purposes, for the possible utilization that is to be supplied, and then again to be used for domestic and commercial purposes. Then heating, we have already discussed producer gas can also be used for heating purposes also. Then again, we can say the byproduct of biomass is ethanol or biodiesel. So biodiesel is basically we are generating it from we can say organic matter, and we have just the filtration of that organic matter of this out of get an ethanol and biogas that can be used for your like biodiesel can be used not as a substitute of a diesel, but it can be used and as an addition to the fuel, where like we can almost save 10 to 20% of the diesel by adding a biodiesel into the diesel. Yes, and that can be a potential, like in that purpose, we are saving a lot of fuel, we can say a substantial quantity of fuel that either the 100% of the diesel would be using for this, but in this case, we can save at least 20 to 25% if the diesel is being saved. That can be comparing it with the consumption of diesel in today's world, like we have a lot of vehicles for the transportation for this, and if we are getting at least saying 20 to 25% of diesel by adding biodiesel to this, then only the all accumulated value can lead to a greater help for reducing the pressure or reducing the reducing the pressure on using that diesel alone as fuel. So it can be used for vehicle transportation here. Like we have already discussed, that can be used in fuel in vehicles. So that can be used for transportation of goods and the services or the people that we normally use. Then the cooking purposes can also be used for cooking purposes in our homes, commercial spaces, and this can also be in substitute for the cooking purposes that for that purpose. And by this we are taking a lot of a load over from the LPGs, or we can take like in the villages we see that is being done by the cooking is mainly done by the wood, and that wood is being wasted by the burning of wood, and that wood can be saved, and that the cooking purpose can be, and the fuel for the cooking purpose can be generated from the your ethanol or biodiesel in this case. Then another is your boiler plus steam turbine. So another we can say the utilization of a biomass is a boiler plus steam turbine. The boiler is used to generation of steam, plus it is when it is used for running the steam turbine, the steam generated is being used for rotating the steam turbine, and by the eventually the rotation of the steam turbine there is generation of electricity, and that can be used for commercial purposes, for industrial processing in this case. Then it can also be used for heating process heat also. Yeah, so we can also be used for heating the process heat, can also be getting from this. Then again, it is biofuel plus gas turbine. So previous one it was boiler steam, another one was biofuel like biodiesel, and other fuels can also be used, and that can be used over from that the heat generated from that biofuel can be used to run the gas turbine. Yes. And that gas turbine, in fact, will be producing the electricity for industrial processing and for heating the process heat. Okay. So that is we are getting on the heat from the biofuels, and that is mean we are getting a process heat, like process heat we are getting out of this, and then we are by the heat we are generating either we can say gases we have generated that are used to run the turbine, or we are generating steam that are used for the generation of steam turbine. So that is we are using it for industrial purposes. So this was the some prominent utilization of biomass. Then what are the properties of biomass? So physical properties and which are properties that are forming are the common important solid fuels for combustion and thermal processing. Then the first one is moisture content. Then what are the things we can say the properties that are being important for the solid fuels for we can say combustion or we can heating or thermal processing for this? Firstly is the moisture content. It should have the moisture content, as the moisture content will be of a, we can say a higher value, it would not be easily it cannot be available for your combustion of this, because as long as we can say the higher will be the moisture content, lower will be the combustion of that particular fuel. So So the moisture content should be as low as possible, because the presence of moisture content lowers the caloric value, lowers the amount of heat that we are getting out of it. Then particle size and size distribution. What is the size of the particles and what is the distribution of that size? Yeah. So that is an important aspect in this. So what is the size of the particle and what is the distribution of that size? So what are the individual size of the particles and what is the distribution of the overall distribution of that size that can be also be used? Then it is the bulk density and specific gravity. Yeah. So what is the bulk density of the biomass here and what is the specific gravity? Because bulk density, that depends upon the overall bulk density of the food. So that it, how it will be burned, and the specific gravity. Specific gravity is also an important property while getting it, the, you can say, possible for your combustion here, or we can say processing in the form of heat. Then higher heating and calorific value. It should have a higher heating and calorific value. The most important thing is calorific value is the amount of heat generated when a unit mass of a substance is burned. When we are talking of a combustion, yeah, so it, we should be noting that it should have a higher heating value, like when the fuel is burned, or when the, we can say the substance is burned for that we are using for the biomass, it should produce greater amount of heat, and plus also the calorific value. Calorific value is the amount of heat that we are generating out of it. Should also be of the higher value, because higher will be the calorific value, higher will be the heating value, better will be the combustion, better will be the heat produced, and better will be the output for which we are, we can say, doing the process for also. Then another is an approximate analysis of sugarcane bagasse at 20% moisture. So this is basically, we can say, approximate analysis of a sugarcane bagasse. And that too with a 20% moisture in this case. So this is the component, this is the mass percent. Clear? So then moisture, it is 20%. Clear? Then moisture for this, we are already taking it 20%. Volatile matter, that is 65.24%. Then fixed carbon, it is having 12.11%. Ash overall in the sugarcane bagasse, that was in 2.65%. Then high heat value. Heat value means milliJoules per kg on dry basis. It is having a high heat value of 19.04% out of this. So this is a common, we can say, talk of the moisture, volatile matter, fixed carbon, ash content, and high heat value. So that all the things should be, we can say, considered for the production of the biomass. Yeah, because we have to be heating this or burning this sugarcane bagasse, so it act, we has to be the properties of that sugarcane bagasse, it should be studied towards it, so that we can get the best out of this, or is it the material is eligible for the generation of biogas. That can only be studied by studying its properties. So we must analyze any product for by before using it for the biomass production. Then now this is, we see the properties of biomass. This is the chemical composition. So chemical composition in the case of your properties for the chemical composition of this. So it should have, we should be knowing the values of the following properties. Now how is the total ash, it is percentage in the percentage term it is having. It is having the total ash in this part. Then it is solvent soluble percent. So how soluble is the solvent in this percentage of that. Then it is water soluble percentage, clear? So how we can say the solubility of the water percent in this case. Then lignin percentage, so what is the, we can say, percentage of the lignin available in this. So then what is the percentage of cellulose that is available, the chemical, that is also chemical composition, important chemical composition, that is the cellulose factor for this. So hemicellulose percentages and hemicellulose percentages. So both are to be considered, both selecting the material for the biomass. Then wood is grouped as either hardwood or softwood. So if we talk of, so wood is normally we considered in two forms, that is the hardwood and softwood. And that is dependent upon the amount of, we can say, percentage of cellulose available in this. So softwoods normally have 40 to 45% of cellulose, 24 to 37% of hemicellulose and 25 to 30% of lignin. So before selecting a wood, we should be knowing about its category, whether it is a hardwood or a softwood. So softwood normally have, that we have discussed, the cellulose quantity of 40 to 45%. Then it is hemicellulose, we can say quantity of 24 to 37%, and the lignin also, that is 25 to 30%. For this hardwood normally contains approximately 40 to 50% of this, we can say cellulose in this case. Then there we see, this is from plant, we get plant cells, these are cell walls. Then inside this is the cellulose inside this plant. Then the structure that is holding out of this, that is the hemicellulose. And the overall, we can say, wall of this part is normally known as your, that is lignin. And if we call all over the plant, that is this, in this case, if we see, this is microfiber for this case. Clear? So this is the hydrogen bond we have seen in this part, that is the ferulic acid and the acetyl. So this is basically the structure for this. So what is that is, we have to take consider the lignin percentage, the cellulose percentage, hemicellulose percentage. So that is all to be studied a post set or before we are adding it into the part of this part. So then again, if we see for this part, so to start with,